The quantum of sentence for 24 convicts in the Gulbarg Society massacre was finally pronounced today by special SIT court. It awarded life imprisonment to 11 out of the 24 convicts, while 12 others were handed 7 years of punishment and one convict was given 10 years imprisonment. On June 2nd, the court had convicted 11 persons for murder and other offences, while remaining 13 others were charged with lesser offences. 69 people, including former Congress MP Ehsan Zafri, were killed in the Gulbarg Society massacre. 14-year-old rape survivor has been allowed by the Gujarat High Court to terminate her 22-week pregnancy. The court contended that abortion was in the best interest of the teenager. The survivor had filed a petition for abortion on the grounds of her tender age. She had stated in the petition that the continuance of the pregnancy would have dire consequences on her health and well-being. According to the Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act, abortion is prohibited beyond a 20-week pregnancy. The constitutional validity of Section 18 of the Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Development Act 2006 was upheld by the High Court of Madras. The petition filed by Refex Energy Limited had said that the company for the supply of galvanized steel structures, solar module mounting structures had placed 3 work orders with Passive Infra Projects Private Limited. But Passive Infra Projects Private Limited, due to disagreement, filed claim petition under Section 18 of the MSMED Act 2006 against Refex Energy Limited. Even after a month, state governments have not complied on the directions of the Supreme Court to provide relief to the drought-affected people, social activists have alleged. The activists who visited the drought-hit areas found that the Supreme Court order on implementing various central schemes to provide relief to distressed farmers remained non-existent. Social activists in a report lambasted the non-compliance of states and centre on the issue, citing that mitigation measures including farm loan restructuring, implementation of midday meal schemes, disbursement of crop loss compensation and providing employment through MGNREGA were not acted upon. In a unanimous decision, the US Supreme Court ruled that the Department of Veteran Affairs was unsuccessful to abide by a law intended at raising the quantity of federal contracts given to small businesses owned by handicapped old-timers. The court upheld the petition of a veteran-owned contractor, King Domeware Technologies, saying that it should have been reckoned to render services for a VA medical center. A Japanese court has upheld an order to halt Takama nuclear reactors. Operator of the reactors Kansai Electric Power said in a statement that it was very regrettable that the petition for stay of execution was not approved, hoping that the court would cancel the injunction soon. On March 9th, the Otsu District Court had ordered Kansai Electric to shut down the reactors in Fukui, the capital of Fukui Prefecture along the Sea of Japan.